All right, Mr. Eazi.
Yes, boss.
Charlie, welcome.
Charlie, thanks, man. Thanks, man.
All right, tell us something about yourself.
Mr. Eazi is that new African sound taking over the world. You know, that'd be the long and short of it all, man.
Let me say you are a Nigerian. How true is that?
Yeah, that's true. I was born in Nigeria to a Nigerian dad. I only came to Ghana because my mom had extended family from Beposo in Kumasi near Konongo. So I came here to meet family and to do school. And I stayed back in Ghana because of the love I was receiving. So after school, I stayed back, started the music. So I see myself as a Gagerian.
A what?
A Gagerian.
That's nice. A Gagerian.
Straight.
Okay, so do you speak any of the local languages?
No, I just understand like small of the tree, like kakra kakra, like yeah, minty, yeah. This guy.
So your career right now, yeah. God's willing, everything is going on well,
yeah.
You're making it big,
yeah.
Okay, what are some of your challenges right now,
man? Basically it's about handling, you know, when this all comes to you, especially when you're not expecting it immediately, in this kind of, you start having challenges with, you know, handling this fame and all of that, you know. And God is helping us, you know, especially, you know, temptation from different sides of,
yeah, I want you to go there, the temptation. Talking about temptation, we heard, yeah, about some girl sending you nude pictures and stuff. How true was that?
Well, it's true. If I bring out my phone right now, yeah. if you give me internet right now, if I bring out my phone, if we go to my private message, you will see a lot. They keep sending it every day, you know, to show how much they love me.
Whoa.
You know, but by God's grace, God is helping us handle all of this. Why not?
Right now, you having a serious girlfriend, or you are single?
I'm single right now, but I'm working on, I'm like 80% almost getting there. You see, sometimes that's one of the challenges you face as a popular person. A lot of girls find it hard to trust you because they say, well, you're a celebrity, you're on TV, and they know a lot of girls are throwing themselves around you. So some girls try to be, you know, defensive. So we're working on it. Hopefully, maybe by next year, January, I would have landed a girlfriend. Then if we're on this show, I'll be telling you, Charlie, I'm engaged, though. Make nobody come near.
Nice. So right now, you are still searching, right?
Yeah, I'm still searching.
Oh, okay, still okay, searching. Okay. Now, I would like to know about the Wizkid endorsement and, yeah, then the contrast stuff.
Yeah.
Did you saw it coming?
Frankly speaking, I didn't see it coming. Okay. I didn't see it coming. I was just doing my music. I went to London in March, okay, to do the Ghana Independence and also do a tour. When I got there, I got a call from Payday first. Payday is like, you, Wizkid wants to meet you. Then I get a call from Mugeez, same thing. Then I get a call from Afia, you know, and we met, we talked, we felt like, okay, let's do this. And we thank God for everything, you know. Yeah.
Can you tell us something about the deal or something? Your fans out there would like to know.
We make everybody just know, see, it's a symbiotic relationship. It's just like, a train,
okay,
you know, a train has to be on a track,
okay.
So being on Starboy Worldwide is like being on a very good track,
okay.
By all means, you move faster.
Definitely.
So that's the long and short of the deal. There's business in between, but you know, say that one, it be law terms, we know go fee bring those ones, but just know there's nobody ripping off anybody. I still they do my thing.
Exactly.
Nobody they stop me from putting out music. Nobody they stop me from doing my concerts. Like,
nice,
everything is still as it's supposed to be, and we thank God. We hope it can continue like this, you know.
All right. So what's up next with Mr. Eazi?
Yeah, I'm starting the Ghana Life is Eazi University tour. So we're going to KNUSD, UCC, Legon, Asese, maybe UDS as well. Also, we're dropping Skin Tight Remix featuring Wizkid at the end of September. About 5 videos are dropping between now and December. I just dropped Dance For Me, Shocky Shocky. Yeah, okay. I dropped the video yesterday. Already 100,000 views on YouTube.
Wow,
you
wow,
know,
wow,
so
wow.
A lot of touring and video drops.
Nice one. There are a whole lot of guys looking up to you.
Yeah.
Some would like to, they are happy for you. Some would like, yeah, to be at where you are now.
Yeah.
What do you have to tell them?
Man, I just feel like if you enjoy what you do and you believe in what you do, you should just continue doing it. And also you should look out for people that have succeeded and try to emulate. Like, at sometimes I go on YouTube and I start watching, say, videos of Fela performing, videos of Chris Brown performing. I start studying how to push my music, all these things. So these are all the things. Once you know that this is what you want to do and you feel you enjoy it, then keep doing it, keep learning, never forget God, and be humble. I've seen some of the biggest artists in the world are the most humble. So you for just be humble, be real, trust in God, and do what you do, man.
Do you watch movies in Ghana?
Just occasionally. I'm not really a movie person, but occasionally if I put on TV, I see some. Then
so who excites you the most?
Liwin, Nkasa Liwin, man. That guy be my best.
Why?
My best actor. I like his originality. I like his freedom.
Okay.
He doesn't act according to the rules. He does his own thing. And that's why I like people that do their own thing, that are original.
So natural.
Yeah, and that's why I like Liwin.
Right. Since you've been able to choose your best actor,
yeah,
being Liwin,
yeah,
musician.
Musician, it will be Mugeez. Mugeez is my best, is the best artist in Ghana.
Wow.
Yeah, Mugeez. Mugeez, because Mugeez is the most spiritual. He has the best rhythms. He has the best lyrics. He can jump, he can do dancehall, he can do R&B, he can do hip life. He can even rap. So Mugeez to me is like an idol.
Wow.
You know, and I feel like he's the best in Ghana.
Nice one. Now we are in an election year.
Yeah,
this year is an election too.
First of all, especially the youths, if you look at everybody that is contesting, say the presidential race for instance, you find out that all of them are above 30. So what does that tell you? They are the past generation. So as youths, we have more to lose if Ghana becomes non-peaceful, or if Ghana becomes basa-basa. We are the ones that have something to lose. They've passed that 30-40 year mark. You know what I'm saying? So all I just have to say is, do not lose your life for the only thing worth fighting for is peace. So make sure you're peaceful, make sure you're very sensitive of the kind of things you say during election period. Never go and do anything for anybody. The only person you should be loyal to is your country, and what your country needs is peace and a good government. Don't allow anybody to buy your votes. Just go there, vote with your conscience. Know that you're embracing peace. At all costs, there must be peace. I know by God's grace, God will help us. We want Ghana to be peaceful. Me, I want Ghana to be peaceful. So how much more you yourself?
Nice one. Yeah. So in between Nigeria, to know that.
The best place I like to stay is Kumasi, not even Accra, Tema. Kumasi is, for me, I feel Kumasi is the best place in the world. Anytime I come here, I just feel peaceful. I don't know. I just feel peaceful. Like there's no giddy giddy in Kumasi. Like I can sleep well anytime I'm in Kumasi. So yeah, that's it.
All right, thank you, bro.
Yeah,